fisherman.
If you will have us, Simon, John and I would like to come to work tomorrow.
Simon, you shouldn't have done that.
Jason, nobody's here, Jason. Jason! It's absolutely over. Last time that
we got a little behind today, Commissioner. We were trying to catch up. I'm sure you can understand.
Oh, yes, I...
You do understand, don't you, Your Honor?
I'm sorry, I was just trying to imagine the long version of the story.
I have a solution, if it pleases the court.
If you can get us out of this, it absolutely thrills the court.
Motion denied.
Hey, I'm the one that's supposed to say that.
It's my first case.
You're kidding.
Oh, I don't know, Joe. I figure if I gotta go, it might just as well be this trip as the next one.
As psychologist of Fernwood's largest plant for 10 years, I've heard about every problem there is. I mean, a little homosexuality, okay, but on your wedding night? Of course, I should have known better. Mary Hartman called me about this case. But a woman who causes her husband to lose a testicle in a motel room? That has got to be the most appalling. That is so disgusting.
They're all like phasers, only worse, whatever they were using. We tried to signal them, we called up, tried to surrender. And women and children, I told them that. I begged them. They wouldn't listen.
I know how very deeply your friendship was treasured by Louise. We are privileged to have with us her favorite nephew. Has more worthy interest to my estate than you could hold a candle to. And being no older than you are, he organizes operations for state senators, lobbies for the small businessman, and has an ambitious 5-year plan for the force that even I would like to support. And then I have to think of you and what a degenerate you are.
life and before Carol, but the moment we met, I knew that something extremely special was happening to me. There was joy every single hour of every day. My spirit and my confidence soared more than any time in my life. And the love I felt for Carol is the kind of love I used to read about in books, but I never experienced. And the moment I met her, it came to me, and I was able to receive it and to offer it. And I'm forever grateful for that. And 2 weeks ago yesterday, we celebrated our 45th wedding anniversary.
And so now, 45 years later, we're approaching the menopause of that marriage. He still brings me coffee in bed. He doesn't make it. He gets it at Starbucks. It's the thought that counts.
In time, the Rockies may crumble. Gibraltar may stumble. They're only made